Welcome to the Chinese lesson for beginners. In the previous lesson, we focused on greetings, their appropriate responses in positive and negative sentences, learned to construct interrogative sentences and understood the different conversations based on the scenario. Now, we will learn some important classroom expressions.
打开书,
which means open your book.
打开书, 打开书, 请大声读,
which means please read aloud.
请大声读, 请大声读, 再读一遍,
which means read once again or repeat.
再读一遍, 再读一遍, 一起读,
which means read together.
一起读, 一起读, 有问题吗?
Which means any questions.
有问题吗? 有问题吗?
Chinese has plenty of exceptions when it comes to pronunciation. We can take 不 as an example. The pronunciation of 不 is in the fourth tone. If the immediate word has any tone other than the fourth tone. For example,
不好, 不
remains in fourth tone, as
好
is in third tone. However, when two consecutive words have the fourth tone, the first word is pronounced in the second tone. For example,
不是,
which means wrong or not right.
不
is pronounced in a rising tone, while
是
remains in the fourth tone. Vocabulary is the building block for any language, which is why our constant focus is on learning new words.
中国,
which means China.
中国, 中国.
It is still a subject of debate as to how the word
中国
came into usage. Some linguistic scholars interpret the translation in literal as the Middle Kingdom, indicating a flourishing and advanced civilization when their nearby contemporaries were still in their baby steps.
美国,
which means USA.
美国, 美国, 中国人,
which means Chinese person.
中国人, 中国人, 美国人,
which means American person.
美国人, 美国人. 老师,
which means teacher.
老师, 老师. 学生,
which means student.
学生, 学生. 叫,
which means to call or address someone.
叫, 叫. 什么,
which means what?
什么, 什么. 名字,
which means name.
名字, 名字. 我,
which means I or me.
我, 我. 是,
which means am or to be.
是, 是. 马,
which is used as a question particle. We already learned about 马, and how to use it to construct interrogative sentences.
马, 马.
Chinese grammar is based on a few fundamentals. That's why learning them is very important, to frame sentences with ease. To be specific about 马, it is a particle which is used in interrogative sentences, which roughly translates to, are you? It is usually added in the end of the sentence. Now, we come to another important exception, which is important in Chinese pronunciation.
李月
is a common Chinese female name. If you notice carefully,
李
is marked with the notation for the third tone, and
月
is marked with the notation for the fourth tone. When a circumstance emerges, When a word with the third tone is followed by a word with a fourth tone, the third tone is pronounced in half. That is to completely ignore the rising notation in the third tone. While studying in Pinyin, these challenges make it slightly complicated to learn Chinese, because a slight notation change will alter the pronunciation and the entire meaning. Li is not pronounced in the fourth tone. Let's construct some sentences based on what we have learned so far.
我叫李月,
which means, I am
李月. 我叫李月. 我叫李月. 你叫什么名字?
Which means, what is your name?
你叫什么名字? 你叫什么名字? 中国老师,
which means, Chinese teacher or a teacher from China.
中国老师, 中国老师, 美国学生,
which means, American student.
美国学生, 美国学生.
We have learned to use pronouns such as
你, 我, 他.
But they are only used to denote a person. To denote an object, we use
这. 这什么?
Which means, what is this?
这什么? 这什么? 这是什么书?
Which means, what book is this?
这是什么书? 这是什么书?
In Chinese, sentences are broadly divided into subject and predicate. The subject takes a name or any pronoun. In the predicate section, we have
是 or 不是,
which means is or is not, according to the table's context. The other part of the predicate is taken by the noun, which can be a name or place as mentioned here. The construction of interrogative sentences follow a similar pattern as the regular sentence. We just add the question particle,
ma,
at the end of the sentence. Once there is a good foundation of grammar and vocabulary, we can enjoy constructing sentences endlessly.
你是老师吗?
Which means, are you a teacher?
你是老师吗? 你是老师吗? 我不是老师, 我是学生.
Which means, I am not a teacher, I am a student.
我不是老师, 我是学生. 我不是老师, 我是学生. 你是中国人吗?
Which means, are you Chinese?
你是中国人吗? 你是中国人吗? 我不是中国人, 我是印度人.
Which means, I am not Chinese, I am Indian.
我不是中国人, 我是印度人. 我不是中国人, 我是印度人.
Thank you for the patient learning. Always keep in mind that practice makes perfect. Especially, it is very necessary to watch out for the tones, and pronounce accordingly. Pinyin is just the platform to get introduced into Chinese language, and not the final level. In the future videos, you will also learn their corresponding Chinese characters and learn to express them at ease.